On My Story today, we bring you the story of Adetokunbo Okoka, also known as MD Koka, a trained broadcaster turned talent manager, and also the story of Babatunde Araga, who from being a shisha attendant in nightclubs became a renowned model. Please stay tuned as today's episode promises to be inspiring as usual.
I'm Adetokunbo Okoka, popularly known as MD Koka. I grew up in Lagos, and I did my primary, state secondary school there, but my secondary school was quite a tough time because I did about 7 secondary school. You know that situation when you get to school, those days of black book, expel and stuff like that. Though I'm a gentle guy though, so don't quote me wrong. In among courses or stuff like that. But I happen to be among friends that are quite, how would I put it, they cause troubles a lot, and I found myself in that category as well. I got expelled, changed schools. Finally though, I did visit one of the sustained motor school in Kaduna. That was where I finished my secondary school before I finally moved to Kano. Yeah, in Kano, I started up with Sani Abacha Youth Center where I did my vocational skills. That's in news reporting though. And I went to NFI, National Film Institute in Jos. There I didn't finish as well. And I moved down to BUK where I studied Mass Comm. Glad at least I was able to achieve something from there as well before finally step into radio. I'm a talent manager. I have about 3 artists that I'm managing. I run PR. I have my own company. In Kano, I was able to have my studio where we do photos and video recordings. I think that was about 2003. 2005, I joined radio, that's Radio Nigeria. I have a lot of experience in radio stuff. That I was even given the studio manager. I think at the end of the day, I'll be the one to put on the gen, the opening prayer, and do the closing prayer in the radio station. It's not been easy though. We've been through a lot here and there. From radio, I moved down to the artist management stuff. I have a couple of artists. I manage Sunny Danger, Nassim, Slim T, Jay Weezy. I run PR for Jay Martins. I was privileged to work with DJ Z's, Da Green, late Da Green. Quite a couple of them though. I keep mentioning names, that will be endless list though. I came from a family that are very free. They give a free hand to everybody. Whatever you think you want to do, they will give you advice, give you the advantage and the disadvantage as well. So it's left for you now to be able to achieve what you want to achieve. But I came from a family that whereby anything you want to do, everybody will give you 100% backup. When you force someone to try to do something, I think in my language, Yoruba, you try to learn how to read Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday in Yoruba. And I got so spoiled that I can't even read it in Yoruba. I was given that task for like 1 month for me to cram it. And I felt very bad because I wasn't able to even come up with it at all. Part of the task that I felt bad about is sometimes I want to watch a program in the night and I will be asked to go to bed by 8 o'clock so that I could wake up earlier in the morning. And I find a situation whereby I have to sneak out and be under the cushion to wait for that timing, put on the TV and get to watch. I was caught once though, but I was lucky enough. But that task of going to sleep when the nature hasn't called yet, it's not easy. I think one of my biggest, most challenging moments is when I was working in a radio station, and I think I tried to do my best to have a qualitative program. And we have this very young boy that knows how to read Quran from the beginning to the end of it. And I think I went out of my way to make sure I get this person to come and have a radio talk show with me. And unfortunately, getting there, we have like 4 media stations, and I was the only person that was granted to have an interview with the person. And getting to the station, I found out that there are a couple of SSS around the station. I was arrested, that I went to bring is it military or Taliban or what do they call it these days. I felt so much embarrassed, and it was so challenging for me that I think I was suspended for like 3 months. But that didn't break me down. That gives me more strength for me to do more, at least. Yeah, a difficult childhood can prevent someone from being successful. That's quite true. Because when, I think from when a child is a kid, you need to learn what he loves and encourage them, give them the best. Choosing a career for your kids, for your children, it's not a good idea. Allow them, let them express themselves. Everybody comes to the world to choose a particular job. Well, if I would correct anything from my childhood days, I think I would go back to my schooling aspect. I really want to correct that. It sounds weird when you say you did seven different secondary schools. And I think I spent one year. So I would like to go back, focus on particular one, and try and finish up right there. I think government should just create a law whereby child's rights will be given to them. And I think there should be an NGO to set aside for the child's rights too. That will help a lot, and that will go a long way. And for the parents, you see, there's something, and the more you ask a child not to go out just a little time, it makes him wonder what's happening that time that you ask him not to go out. I would love to have that such experience. So it seems when you're trying to prevent your children from doing something that is wrong, that's when they get into it. Only if they could have experience of it, and they will get to understand which is bad, which is wrong, which is good. I won't say I'm lucky to get to where I am. I think I'm blessed. And I worked for it, I struggled for it, I passed through a lot, went through a lot, but thank God this is where I am today. I'm doing fine, I'm not that rich, but I'm doing fine.
Still to come.
You've been a youth, you can venture into so many things. Because now, in this our present generation, I really talk about education. Yeah, apart from education, you need to have something like a handwork.
Baba God bless you, no go pass you by. He go bless you, so to them go ask you.
No cutter, you know what I say, you know go drive home. Everybody just self your water. You know what I say, I like the full gutter. But I'm still up and them by. I'm really making my
gift and all the glory. When I walk out, everybody say they know me. And I keep on all the glory. I started singing, I tell them my story.
My name is Babatunde Shosonya Nurudeen Araga. I'm from Lagos State. I was born in Lagos State and raised in Lagos State. I left Lagos to my grandmom due to my dad's job. You know, he's got a very ethic job. So I went to St. Anthony Nozian Primary School in Jebude. From there, I went to Jebude Grammar School, which, you know, is one of the popular secondary school in Ogun State. So we were the likes of Wizkid, D1, so many stars in Nigeria. When I'm talking about stars, I'm talking about media, social media and stuff like that. So I'm the first of the family. I'm the so you about to say I'm the head of the family. I really, you know now, and I've got a very good family. When I was growing up, you know, there were some tasks my grandmom usually tell me to do whenever I go wrong in any aspect. Like coming back from school, I wouldn't wash my socks and put my books into places, you know, stuff like that. You know, for her to get to me, she just tell me, okay, because she's got this big depot in Ogun State in her house. She would just tell me, okay, for you not doing the right and the proper thing, this is what you have to do. Go to the depot, get 6 crates of soft drinks and come home. You know, I'll be like, how can I carry 6 crates of, you know? I was just like, oh. Then the next thing, she just like, you know, she just start telling you something like your adage, something that will make your head swell, like to know where you're coming from. For example, she says, "Omo kose aton aton rikalu, adelo malo parankale, omo lawo joda, omo witan gbenu, omo maseko omaba." You know, stuff like that. You know, so the next thing I was just ginger. Like, man, my hair would just swell. Like, yeah, I'm not a bastard. I'm the true son of my father. You know, I'll just go right away. I'll just do it for the fact because she said all those stuffs, and you know, but the task wasn't really easy like that. But I just have to do it. I actually started being a shisha guy, you know, in the club. Like, I run shisha for my friends. I work in the club. Later from there, I became a hype man, a very serious hype man, which I found joy in it. So some of my friends who come to the club and or the garden, wherever I am, they tell me, man, guy, you good, man. Why can't you just run up for a model? Just try and go for a competition. Like, you're good to go. Like, you have the physique and you've got the talent and the brain and stuff like that. I'm like, come on, man. I don't know. Well, let me just try. And I've got this very good friend of mine, a lady. Her name is Grace anyway. You know, she motivates me. She be like, man, Araga, you need to do this, man. Like, you can just do it. Like, you're a good model and stuff like that. Just go for it. Then I was like, okay, let me try. So I just, I got to hear about a competition in Lagos, which was held in Lagos, Aleki. Mr. Ideal Nigeria. Yeah. So I filed in. I was auditioned, I was screened, and I got picked. Then went through the normal processing, and I found myself among all the 36 contestants they picked. So I actually represent Lagos. I was one of the runner-up at the competition, Mr. Edis 2016, which was a March, yeah. So I happen to be Mr. Ideal Nigeria ECOWAS Ambassador 2016. I've got a lot of motivations because I motivate myself as well. But basically, I got so many motivations from reggae music. Because whenever you listen to reggae music, you know something serious you're getting a serious message, a conscious message, you know, because even in the scripture, the Bible says it's better for a man to listen to the book of the wise than hear the songs of fools. You know, when we break it down, you see, nowadays, the lives of Bob Marley, Fela, Nicola Kukuti, Lucky Dube, so on and so forth, they only preach the truth. They only give voice to the voiceless, you know. So whenever you listen to reggae songs, you know, you will know where you're coming from and definitely where you're going to. So I would say that's the book of the wise, you understand? And the songs of fools, we shouldn't just go there because we know. Let's just leave that one aside. I would say I'm very lucky. Why I would say I'm very lucky is because I said before, everything is by the grace of God, you know. In one way or the other, we just have to give thanks to God, because there is no how, there is a there's something that will make you say, wow, God, thank you. Because whenever you look at yourself and you see someone else as well, like, it's not up to you, be like, wow, God, thank you, thank you, thank you. If truly you know your being, you can't, I mean, you know, okay, there's God, you know. So I'll say I'm very lucky to be a mother. I'm very lucky because I worked out, and so many of my friends that we worked out together didn't get to where I got. It's not that I'm just saying it, but it's just by the grace of God, you know. So I'm a lucky dude. I think difficult childhood can prevent a child from being successful. And at the same time, no, I think difficult childhood can prevent a child from being successful as well. Now, yes, in the sense that if a child is not brought up in the rightful environment, if the child family is, maybe the dad and the mom keeps fighting, insulting each other, different abusive stuff, languages, is really, really gonna affect the child. The upbringing too matters a lot. The environment matters a lot. So I can say that can really, yes, it can affect the upbringing of a child. I know in the sense that we've got a lot of people like they are from poor background, difficult backgrounds, you know, so many, like countless, like, you know, they strive so hard because they knew there's nothing for them. They just have to get up and do what they have to do. Like, they have this zeal, like, I want to be this, I want to be successful, I want to be this and that, you know. It's just both ways. It's 50-50. If I have the opportunity to relive my childhood, what would I have done? Everything is just cool. Like, I wouldn't have done something I've never done. You know, everything I'm doing today is just meant to be. So I would just be me, man. I'll just do what I can do all over again. You know, I think the government and parents are the major key for the upbringing of a child. Firstly, the home, the parents, comes before the government. Because if the home is not well built, if the father and the mother of a child are not doing the proper thing for a child, you know, it's going to go wrong. And tell me, if a child is wrong in the house, in his home or in a home, how much can the government do? So the basic is from the home. For example, you see so many parents, like, they don't want to care what their child is going through in school. All they tell the child is, Babatunde, you have joined bad gang. You don't know, see the son of Mr. this one, you know, it's bad. Like, you don't compare your child with another child. The destiny of your child is different from the destiny of your neighbor's child. So I think if the parents do the rightful thing at home, government will do what they need to do. Because it's just simple. If the foundation is not strong, how can the building stand? One day it's just going to collapse. Even the cement and everything is 100% or 110%, it's still going to fall because the foundation is bad. Now, the parent is the foundation and the government is the building. It won't stand. Now, people will now blame the government is not doing this, the government is not doing that. But at the same time, government needs to do a lot too. You know, like providing scholarship. You know, we know the country is really facing recession right now and so many things is going on. But notwithstanding, please, first of all, to the parents out there listening to me, please try to call your child, your children, get more closer to them, ask them what's really going on. Because there are so many things they are going through, like, they won't want to say if you don't get closer to them. Ask them what's going on in school. is someone telling you stuff like you don't want to hear, just ask them random questions, like to bring them to open up to you, the parents. So from there, I think the whole country will get better and the youth will know where they are going through and where they are coming from. And so also to the government, they should do what they have to do. Because if I start saying they should do this, they do that, people before me have already said that. They should do what they have to do. Because since I was in primary school, they tell me I'm the leader of tomorrow. And if I should tell you my age now, I don't know how many people I've led, you know. But still, Nigeria is a great country. We are blessed. We just need to help ourselves. The parents need to help their kids before the government comes in, you know. So that's just it. Anything you want to become is possible. If you believe God is possible, everything you want to do is possible. Before I got to this height, you know, I've done so many things outside the box, you know. I've went my way to be an hype man. I've went my way to be a shisha guy, you know. I don't even do PIMP safe. You know, so you can be anything you want to be. Anything, as in, just put your mind into it, work hard, have focus, tell yourself, I know I can do this, and trust me, you will achieve anything you want to achieve. Let me tell you something, if you don't work hard, and you're not consistent with whatever you think you're doing, and you're not going anywhere. But if you work hard, you're consistent, and you put everything in the hands of God, I'm telling you, everything will work out. You don't even just need to think about it. Everything will fall in place and everything will be perfect. Just be focused. Anything you want to become, write it down and tell yourself, I want to become this. Definitely there will be obstacles, right? Just keep on striving. You're going to get there. There are so many examples around you. When you look at your left, you see an example. When you look at your right, you see an example all over you. So just work hard and believe. And believe anything is possible. You've been a youth, you can venture into so many things. Because now, in this our present generation, we really talk about education. Yeah, apart from education, you need to have something like an handwork. You understand? Because your education is tested, okay, already. But sometimes the education, if you look at the country, where the country is going at, how many graduates we have that are out there that are seeking for job, you know? But we have a very good handwork, like something you learn, you know? You learn, you can do with your initiative, like you can think of something that you just bring into existence, like, okay, fine, I think, let me do this. Let me put one and one together to get to, and let me just put this. Just think of something creative, you know. Nigeria, we've got a lot of resources that we can work on. Like these glasses I'm wearing now, they say, is part of my effort, striving hard to be who I want to be. Like, I want to be somebody in life, you understand? So you just have to work hard. Don't ever sleep. Like these glasses now was inspired by a guy in India, you know. When the guy saw me on Instagram, it was like, wow, okay, for you being an ambassador of ECOWAS, let's collaborate, let's do something together so we can achieve something. And for the name to tally up again, because everybody knows me as Araga, Hype Man Araga, you know. So you follow my Instagram, King Araga. So now we worked in hand together, giving some ideas, we shared ideas, like, okay, make it like this, let's have this kind of shape, this kind of design, you know, and we keep on something. And I've got so many friends. If you look at DJ Anymoney now, Olamide's personal DJ, go to his page, you see he's putting on the glasses. I've got so many celebrities rocking it, you know. It's just so cool, like, under the sun. You can't just put on something iron under the sun. You just get burnt and stuff. So these wooden glasses now, we just cool everything. It's not going to get hot. It's just going to be as normal and cool, you know, and simple as it is. So I'll advise you, youth, anything you put your mind into, you can achieve anything. I want to make a very big shout out to my family and friends, my dad and my mom, my grandmother, Alaja Araga. You know, I want to make a very big shout out to them. I want to say a very big thank you to them. And my family and my friends as well. You know, King Murak Selassie, respect, brother, wherever you are. Olamide, I'm not talking about Badu, you know, nah. And as well as Badu, Tipsy Araga, all my well wishers, I want to say a very big thank you to you. Thank you for supporting me.
And that's it on My Story Today. For your comments and suggestions, please send a text or WhatsApp message to 0806-004-2843. Thank you for staying tuned.